déjà assez de temps.
That is, they don't spend enough time on Facebook, obviously, so they should just spend more time.
Une question pour Rachel. Oui.
C'est une question pour Rachel et Laurel.
Oui.
Je voudrais savoir si jamais elle devait sortir avec un personnage d'Hell World, avec qui ce serait.
Si elle devait sortir avec un personnage de Hell World, avec qui ce serait.
Finally! Thank you!
Moi, je serais bien retour à l'envoyeur, okay. Mais bon.
Remember you have your wild cards. Remember you have the wild cards. The question is, for each of you, if you were to date anyone, any character from the L word, which, in real life, which one would it be?
Us, as individuals?
Yeah, dating a character from the L word.
Who would Rachel date?
Yeah, who
but
would
just
Laurel
the character?
Date? Like, would Laurel date Shane? Something like that. Would Laurel date... Would you date... You did Rachel, you date Helena?
I date Tina, definitely. Tina's the sort of most well-adjusted, all-round, beautiful, lovely woman, right?
Dis, c'est la plus belle, la plus difficile, donc...
I have
the most
fabulous life.
Elle aurait une fabulous girlfriend.
I take that back, because if she's only going to date Helena because she's beautiful, rich.
But it's Laurel who would date you for being rich, but not Tina. Tina would never do that, just Laurel.
Wait, I have to tell. That's funny you said that, because I'll tell a really quick, I'll try to be
I
quick.
I just need to
sorry.
Explain what we just said, because... Sorry.
Sorry, you're there.
Donc... Elle veut sortir avec Tina, elle veut sortir avec Helena parce qu'elle aurait une vie fabuleuse et la copine la plus jolie. Donc elle a dit, bah dans ce cas-là, si elle est aussi superficielle, peut-être pas sortir avec elle. Je fais, non, Laurel, elle est superficielle, pas Tina. Voilà. Et là, du coup, ça vient de... Apparemment, elle a une anecdote qu'elle veut dans le campagne. Go ahead. Tell your story.
There was the sex scene in the pool and there was dialogue that we didn't like. Remember this? And... Helena was new into the show, and I felt like the dialogue was just a little bit not very authentic to get the six-month pregnant person who had been betrayed into the bed and, you know, to seduce her. And I was sitting in Eileen's office, and we had a meeting about changing the dialogue, and I said, why do I sleep with her? I'm pregnant, my heart's been broken, and I was pregnant in real life. And I said, I love that we're making the character sexual, but why? And when she says, I mean, it was, the lines were like what a guy would say in a bar. Like, they were really cheesy. They weren't Helena's lines. They didn't feel authentic. They were a little too slick. And then Eileen goes, because she's so beautiful. And then I looked up and I said, yeah, so we just established that I'm not a shallow character, so wouldn't I need more than beauty? And then at that moment, we realized that it would be that Helena had a way of making Tina feel beautiful after feeling insecure, being broken up with, and being pregnant. And then we had a scene.
And nurturing the fact that you were pregnant, because also there was the whole thing that Bette hadn't noticed, and the whole thing, like, I love the pregnancy. That was the whole thing for Helena, wasn't it? That she thought it was the most erotic.
We have a really good scene.
What you said that was... Anyway. We had really good...
It's just, I mean, it's beautiful. It's beautiful. It was beautifully lit.
Yeah. It looks beautiful.
La scène de la piscine.